On Billboard tonight, Michelin-starred chef and international restaurateur Marco Pierre White, folk music legend Julie Felix, and a gorgeous performance from Penelope Cruz in Film Review. Welcome to Billboard with me, Ted Stanley, for a roundup of theatre, music, art and literature in East Yorkshire and North Lincolnshire. And a special welcome tonight to South African author Athol Williams, who is encouraging hope and freedom in the first ever Cape Flats Book Festival. And with the summer festival season in full swing here in the UK, we feature some of the best on tonight's programme, starting with an award-winning international arts festival in Hull, which also has freedom as its theme.
I know that in terms of the accommodation that we have to deal with all the incoming artists, there's at least over 400 individual artists in that programme, so it's a massive body of work. You've got shows that play for 10,000 people, you've got shows that play for one person at a time. The range of work is extraordinary. It takes place in the city centre of Hull. We use some areas in the Fruit Market, Queen Victoria Square, King Edward Square, Trinity Square. There's a pop-up choir that happens in the market. There's tents in Queen's Gardens with some extraordinary indoor circus work from all over the world. There's fantastic places just to hang out as well. If you're not here to come and see the show, just come and hang out in Queen's Gardens. The whole area there is going to be fantastic. It's quite circusy and a bit kind of carny in a really fun way. It's going to be a lot of fun there. Music stage in Everybody's Yard, amazing music programme from all over the world. We've got acts from Brazil, Sierra Leone, some friends from Sierra Leone are coming over because it's the 40th anniversary of Freetown and Hull's civic twinning. So we've invited a couple of bands from Freetown, which is really exciting. So it's everything from spoken word to exhibitions to big bands on stages to a crazy punk infused daydream on Friday night, which you can't miss, called Generic Vapeur, doing a piece of work called Bivouac, which is a show that's been touring all over the world for 30 years, and I'm really, really proud to finally manage to get this show to come to Hull.
The Hull Freedom Festival starts on the 30th of August. Tickets from www.freedomfestival.co.uk. Hugh is also in a festive mood as he brings this month's book review from his summer retreat on Spain's Costa Brava.
Hola, Ted. Welcome to sunny Spain. Firstly, a Spanish story. Salman Rushdie's new novel Quixote, or Quixote, is a retelling of the Don Quixote story set in America. The title character is not a doleful knight of La Mancha, enraptured by romantic chivalry, but a travelling salesman who can't distinguish reality from the television shows that obsess him. He even has a travelling companion, an imaginary son called Sancho, naturally, with whom he quests across America looking for love. Rushdie supplies all his usual wit and observation in this pastiche of picaresque. Rod Liddle is a journalist, broadcaster, polemicist, and arch supporter of Brexit. In The Great Betrayal, he complains that Brexit had a majority, had a mandate, and then 3 years later, it is not an event, but a process. He suggests this was inevitable and blames a liberal establishment of business, politics, the civil service, and the media. What he doesn't mention is the fact that these are exactly the people who know what they're talking about, but Brexit has had enough of experts. Liddle is always amusing. More historical nonsense set on the sea behind me. Pirata is a swashbuckling pirate tale set in 25 AD under the peaceful rule of the Romans. Simon Scarrow and TJ Andrews have co-written the novel, or Scarrow has lent his brand name to it, known as he is for ancient historical fiction. Our hero, a Greek sailor, is captured by pirates, joins them, and rises to lead them against Roman Imperium. Rubbish, of course. The Mediterranean had been cleared of pirates 80 years before this story is set, and only the most emotional nationalist could see the Roman peace as a bad thing. Rod Liddle, perhaps. Extraordinary Popular Delusions and the Madness of Crowds by Charles Mackay was published in 1841, examining the folly of mass psychology. Now, Douglas Murray has paid his respects with his own title, The Madness of Crowds, exasperated by the issues that divide the modern Western world. Political and religious ideology, he argues, have been replaced by the politics of gender, sexuality, race, and technology, by identity politics. Of course, these are not really identities achieved by will and decision, but descriptions of irrelevant natural coincidence. Murray is clearly rather angry. This might not be one for the beach. Salud, pesetas, Y tiempo para gustarles, Ted. Adios from Spain.
Adios, Hugh. Te veo pronto. In other literary news, a new children's book by local author Sarah Smith featuring augmented reality will be launched at Grimsby Masonic Hall on the 13th of September. And submissions for the Hammond House International Writing Competition for poetry, short stories and screenplays will close on the 31st of September. You can enter now at hammondhousepublishing.com. Other festivals include a celebration of the 40s and 50s with Step Back in Time at the Wall Garden Bomber on the 31st of August and the Beverly Chamber Music Festival on the 25th of August features winners of the BBC Young Musicians of the Year. Tony Barker went to find out more from co-director Libby Burgess.
Martin Roscoe, who's one of the most famous pianists in the country, has been the artistic director of that since it began, and he is still absolutely at the heart of that. So he and I are now joint artistic directors of that, and the management of it is run by New Paths. And so for us, it's amazing to have these two festivals at opposite ends of the year, the Spring Festival and then the Chamber Music Festival at the last weekend of September. And that is a slightly different emphasis from the April Festival, whereas in April we bring lots of singers and players to the town for a few days and sort of mix and match them in lots of different concerts. In September, we bring existing groups, if you like, existing acts to come to Beverley and perform a concert. So some of the great string quartets, piano trios, violinists from the classical music world.
The festival runs from the 21st to the 28th of September. Tickets from newspassmusic.com. Now, here's Kirsty Hannah with a roundup of some of the other music events around the region.
LA Rockers Crazy Town are celebrating 20 years since the release of their debut album, The Gift of the Game. They head to O'Reilly's in Hull on Wednesday, the 28th of August, as part of an exclusive run of intimate shows. Taking inspiration from the deserts of southern Utah, the Three Hat Trio create music that responds to the natural world of their sacred homeland near Zion National Park. You can see them at the Ropery Hall in Barton on Thursday, the 5th of September. On the Water in Cleethorpes have a great lineup of acts this month with folk legend Julie Felix on Friday the 23rd of August and a stunning lineup of professional musicians, the Rumble Band, perform the most exciting live tribute to the sounds and soul of Motown on Friday the 30th of August. Say what? Reg Muros will be presenting his powerful song cycle, 12 Silk Handkerchiefs, at Grimsby Fisherman's Chapel on Friday the 13th of September. Joined by musicians Mick McGarry and Sam Martin, Reg's powerful songs tell the story of Hull's triple trawler disaster and are interwoven with narration from author Brian W. Lavery and an audiovisual show that includes rarely seen archive footage, photos and audio from the time of the tragedy.
I am a fish house woman, my husband works away. He's a techie on the trawlers, and I work a 9-hour day. The knife is sharp and cunning. some say, just like my tongue.
Colm Sands, a universal storyteller who draws on a long Irish tradition of poetic musicality to weave songs for the world, will be at Grimsby Folk Club on Sunday, the 15th of September. And finally, you can hear an extraordinary voice which is full of character when award-winning singer-songwriter Greg Russell appears at the club on Sunday, the 22nd of September.
Six brave men, we've read your story, the trial, the grief, the pain and the glory, and the hand, the squire, the Whig and the Tory in England's pleasant land.
The standard of catering at events has come a long way in recent years as festival goers demand a wider range of gourmet food. A local supplier who is responding to this challenge brought Michelin star chef and restaurateur Marco Pierre White to Grimsby in search of the best ingredients for his international restaurants.
Well, the secret of cooking, whether you're in a pub, whether you're in a high-end restaurant, whether you're on a boat with wheels, like Roro, is you've got to have fabulous quality to begin with. You've got to have the finest of ingredients.
We're here to launch Roro. Eventing catering has come a long way since the burger and chip van. What are people's expectations these days, Patrick?
I think they want a better quality of fast food, if you like, and they also want to understand that it's sustainable and it is a good quality and it's a little bit more artisan, if you will. And fish, you've got to remember, fish is the last wild, organic, hunted, low-fat, sustainable food source. But fish is really, really underrated, and Grimsby here are renowned for processing brilliant, brilliant fish. So, you know, very, very important.
And the reason why I insist that we use Enderby's smoked haddock, smoked salmon, because for me it's the finest in the world. And I'll tell you why it's the finest in the world. Number one, the quality of fish that comes through that door behind you is the finest money can buy. But what makes it very special is, one, that the smokers are over 100 years old. So they've built up that tar, which creates that incredible flavour. Secondly, is the methods that they use. But the specialness is that you taste the fish and you get the scent of the smoke. A lot of smoked haddock, a lot of smoked salmon, a lot of kippers. In my opinion, the smoke is too dominant, and that's why I don't use them. So when I do use them, I always come to Grimsby.
If you want a taste of smoked fish worthy of a Michelin-starred restaurant, look out for Roro at summer events around the region, or go to alfredenderby.co.uk. You can see the extended interview with Marco Pierre White at youtube.com/billboardtv. Now, from a legendary chef to a legendary folk singer, in the 1960s, Julie Felix brought folk music into the mainstream with her albums and TV show. Still recording and touring in her 80s, I caught up with her at a recent gig in Skegness. So, Julie, thanks for joining us on Billboard today. You first came to England in the 60s, 1964?
Yeah, I think I actually came in 63, and my first album was released in 64.
Okay.
And I was the first folk singer to sign with a major label, so that sort of like opened up the future.
The whole world of folk for people, yeah. Mm. Yeah. I think one of your early influences, not so much for your music, but your lifestyle, was some of the beat poets like Jack Kerouac.
Yeah, I mean, that was why I kind of wanted to travel. It was definitely Jack Kerouac on the Road that influenced me to just go and taste life.
Rather be a hammer than a name. Yes, I would.
On your travels, you also met someone who I think became a lifelong friend, and that's Leonard Cohen.
Yeah. I was just thinking. Apparently, there's just a film that's come out about Marianne and Leonard. And I know they came and interviewed me once, but I didn't know if it was part of the thing or not, but my friends wrote me and said that, yeah, I am part. So I'm really touched because Marianne was a dear friend of mine as well.
Yeah.
And to lose them both in the same year was really devastating.
Yeah. Like the shoreline and the sea, but let's not talk of love or change, things we can't untie. Also, before your own show, you were part of probably the most avant-garde piece of television of the time with David Frost. We're going to the zoo, zoo, zoo. How about you, you, you? You can come too, too, too. We're going. And after your success during the 60s and 70s and early 80s with an album every year and various singles, you stopped.
Yeah, I got a bit fed up with the sort of commercial side of everything.
Mm.
And so I stopped singing and I went back to California for a while.
Mm.
And I got involved with yoga and meditation, those things of sort of soul searching, you know.
Mm.
And then I decided there was still a lot to sing about. So I came back to England and started singing.
So how do you view the world now compared with the world as it was in the 60s when we grew up?
Well, there was a lot more optimism in the 60s. In the 60s, we were concerned, we wanted to change the world. Mm. Now I just go, oh my God, you know, what's going to happen?
Mm.
And I mean, I'm still singing and still praying and still doing my rituals to try to bring good energy into the world.
Well, Julie, you're a great inspiration to people of my generation that grew up with you when you were in the 60s, and a great inspiration to the new generation of young people and folk singers. Thanks for joining us on Billboard. It's a
You can see Julie at Moon on the Water in Cleethorpes on the 24th of August, at the Cottingham Folk Festival on the 25th, and in Whitby on the 26th. And the full interview with Julie is at youtube.com/billboardtv. After the break, more amazing festivals to visit, art and poetry in the Lincolnshire coast, and a gorgeous performance from Penelope Cruz in Film Review. Rather be a hammer than a nail. Yes, I would, if I only could. The Lincolnshire Rural Activities Centre, set in an area of outstanding natural beauty, is renowned for its superb equestrian facilities and home to the local Pony Club, North Links Riding Club and Lincolnshire Wolves Riding for the Disabled. More about booking facilities, supporting the centre or volunteering, call 01507 608855 or visit the centre website. Coming up on tonight's show, art and poetry combine in Project Fitties, and a spectacular treat for residents and visitors to Cleethorpes with the Festival of the Sky. But first, here's Class Act's David Wrighton with our choice of the latest film releases.
On Film Review tonight, Wild Horses in Texas, Dreams Within Dreams, and the Romans in Britain. But first, Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, the eagerly anticipated ninth film from controversial director Quentin Tarantino. Expect the usual visual feast and epic performances in this dreamy meander through 1969 Tinseltown, with a nod to the darker side of life as Sharon Tate weaves seductively through the fabric of the story towards her fatal destiny at the hands of Charles Manson.
Telling you and me, That can all change like that.
Under Pedro Almodovar's nimble direction, Pain and Glory tells the tender story of an aging film director played by Antonio Banderas, who is facing ill health, depression, and a decline of his powers until he meets an old friend and combatant. A film within a film, a dream within a dream, it has a wonderful richness and warmth thanks to the cinematographer José Luis Alcaine and a gorgeous performance from Penelope Cruz.
32 años me ha costado reconciliarme con esta película.
Si no escribes ni ruedas, ¿qué vas a hacer?
Vivir, supongo.
Ten cuidado conmigo, eh.
Tú eres muy novelero.
Estoy con Salvador Mayo.
In Laura de Clermont-Tonnerre's Mustang, a violent prisoner who enters a program to train wild horses finds the healing bonds that can form between tormented people and the misunderstood animals that come to their rescue. With a nod to Andrew Hayes' Lean on Pete, reviewed in an earlier program, and with gentle traces of the Western genre, Mustang is a powerful but tender film about forgiveness and second chances, are not as predictable as you might expect.
There you go.
I was a kid, and you left me alone.
It was an accident.
You think riding horses can change anything?
I'm not who I used to be.
Horrible history fans who read the books and watched the TV series can now see it on the silver screen. Rotten Romans features Roman teenager Atti, played by Sebastian Croft, who is forced into the army and sent into battle against the rebelling Brits. He's soon captured by would-be Celtic warrior Orla, played by Emilia Jones, and the two forge an unlikely friendship.
You know. My troops have smashed Boudicca to pieces.
Who are these guys?
Those are trees.
I knew that.
As thousands head to join Boudicca's rebellion, it is nose to tail out there.
Oh. Oh. Get out there to give it CX%.
Wow. Lovely, bring up a flush, Cedric.
That's just a push.
Let's bounce.
Bye. You seriously think the Romans can be bested by a girl?
Bested. On DVD and Blu-ray, Clute from Criterion Collection, Cruising from Arrow Video, and The Incident from Eureka Classics are also.
David is currently in rehearsals for his latest production, Blunderbuss, due to premiere in November. You can see a full review of this month's choices by film critic Paul Lewis at youtube.com/billboardtv. Joining Julie Felix in the lineup at the Cottingham Folk Festival is Bristol-based blues, country and rock singer Alice Bailey. Tony Barker went to meet her.
Els, tell me about the beauty of bringing a show like this here to East Yorkshire.
I'm really excited to come to Cottingham. I've wanted to play this folk festival for a while, so I got the call to come and play. And the night before, I'm in France, so I was like, right, how can I make this work? And we've made it work. So I'm going from France to Cottingham, and it's going to be amazing. And I'm bringing my whole band. So.
Wow, that's two contrasts, France to East Yorkshire. Well, first of all, how's that going to work? Because you're going to be worn out, aren't you?
Well, hopefully not. I'm hoping we're not. So we fly from Bristol to Limoges, we play a show near Limoges, then we drive 3 hours to Bordeaux to then fly to Stansted, and our tour manager will pick us up and take us from Stansted to Cottingham.
You really must have wanted to play this festival.
I definitely did, yeah. So we're really going to bring it and bring lots of excitement to the festival.
So what is it about Cottingham that is so much on the map that you've got to make all this effort to be here?
Well, I've always really enjoyed just seeing the lineups. So I like to keep my fingers on the pulse roles and that type of thing. And I thought, do you know what, I want to play Cottingham. And I said to my agent, I want to play Cottingham this year. And he got it for me. And he got it on the day that the Wandering Hearts were playing. And they're good friends of mine. So it's a great excuse to catch up with them as well. So, you know, when you're on the road, you don't often get to see people. So I was like, I am making this work. So, yeah, Cottingham and the Wandering Hearts.
The Cottingham Folk Festival runs from the 22nd to the 25th of August. Tickets from evanbright.co.uk. Also in Yorkshire, the first High Welsh Poetry Festival is being organised by East Riding Museums. Tony Barker caught up with festival director Julian Woodford.
We're accepting work at the highwoldspoetry at gmail.com. It's for open mic applications until the 20th of September. The festival itself is in North Dalton at the Village Hall in North Dalton on the 21st of September, but we're also going to have a book which we are taking entries for until the 31st of August. So we're going to get the book sorted first, and the book will be there on the day. But it's literally open to anybody from the area, anybody has any connections for the area, so anybody of any age. So it could be 103, you know, it's not discriminatory at all. And as I said, it's really open to anybody in the local community to try and help develop their voices.
The festival is at the North Dalton Book Fair on Saturday, the 21st of September. Entry is free. Warming Bells is a new art exhibition at the North Sea Observatory that warns of the perils of global warming. It follows the installation of the Time and Tide Bell on Mablethorpe Beach in June. The exhibition runs from the 21st of August until the 1st of September. Entrance is free. And you can find out more about the Mablethorpe Time and Tide Bell at youtube.com/billboardtv. Now, here with news of other art exhibitions around the region, a warm welcome back to Billboard for Sarah Hunter-Carson.
A major partnership exhibition at the Ferrans Gallery in Hull features over 120 artworks, providing a dynamic and diverse vision of Britain and British art from the Ingrams and Ferrans collections. The Reflections exhibition includes work by David Hockney, Barbara Hepworth and Henry Moore. Dinosaur Encounter at the Lincoln Collection until the 15th of September is a thrilling exhibition from London's Natural History Museum that transports you back in time with impressive animatronic dinosaurs featuring a roaring T-Rex, lifelike models and fossil replicas. Also in Lincoln, the Usher Museum Gallery offers a range of art-based activities for children of all ages throughout the summer holidays, with the chance to dress up as a princess or a knight, design your own shield or medieval pot, and even make your own artwork to hang on the masterpiece wall. The Louth Art Gallery features an exhibition by award-winning watercolourist Carol Butler, whose work was previously shown at the Mall Gallery in London, the Ferrans Gallery in Hull, and the Usher Gallery in Lincoln. Also in Louth, the Riverhead Gallery features work by local acrylic artist Michael Warren, whose unusual perspectives create unique artwork.
Art and poetry combine in a project that explores and celebrates the rich heritage of a unique community on the Lincolnshire coast.
People have come and stayed here since before the First World War in ad hoc buildings and shelters. And as time progressed, the chalets became more permanent. So my chalet here, it's been here since the 1920s. It's still the original building. And this whole concept that the heritage of the chalets is important, and as people move in and develop the chalets, is to try and maintain that overall feeling of natural materials, and that chalets fit in with the design guide, which is put in place really to maintain the heritage of the site.
We've been working on the Humberston Fitties since 2013. We did a big project here in 2016 with another artist, Annabel McCourt, but now we've come back. We've been working with other artists who live locally.
When Project Fit is when Judith and Harriet first came round, it gave an opportunity for owners of the chalets here to just share their experiences of living and staying and being downhill on this heritage chalet park.
We wanted to see how poetry and art could work together in exhibition, also in artist books like this. So we make concertina books, and you can see that I work as a poet in a very open form way. So sometimes my work is actually sort of dancing around the paintings on the wall in vinyl form. So
it's about bringing together those really complicated things that make up what the idea of place or landscape is.
You can see the full story of Project Fitties at youtube.com/billboardtv. A spectacular event awaits residents and visitors to Cleethorpes in September, when the Festival of the Sky brings a long weekend of arts and culture with free performances, activities and workshops for festival goers of all ages. I caught up with one of the organisers, Becky Donnell, to find out more.
It's a brand new festival that's coming to Cleethorpes from Friday the 6th of September through the whole weekend. It's a celebration of arts and culture, and it's something really special that I really think is going to wow Cleethorpes. It's basically going to be everything from street theatre, live performances, music, there's spectaculars, hot air balloons, kite festival. It all kicks off on the Friday night here at the Discovery Centre. There's an immersive fire garden, which is not to be missed. On the Saturday, there's street performances, there's choirs, there's bands, all kinds of stuff taking place. The hot air balloons are planned for the Saturday night, and that's going to be taking place at the Meridian, and that's obviously going to be quite of a wow, Saturday showcase. And then on the Sunday is the parade. So slightly different to what Cleethorpes would usually expect in a parade, because we're used to the floats and the carnivals. Very much a celebration of the sky. Most of the activity is free as well, which is great, so it's all about bringing the family here, getting involved and really experiencing something new. And it is something that is really going to be a celebration of heritage, but in a completely new manner. It's certainly, when we describe it as ambitious, that's exactly what it is. It's something that we'd like to think is completely new to the area.
Festival of the Sky runs for 3 days from Friday the 6th of September, and don't miss the immersive fire garden at the Discovery Centre on the opening day. Now, here's news of what else is on where you are in box office, including an old-time music hall featuring one of the Billboard team. Now, I wonder who that could be.
That wouldn't be me, would it, Ted? You can enjoy a great night out and support a worthwhile cause when local impresario Monty Martin presents an old-time music hall with an all-star cast at the Joseph Wright Hall in Barton-upon-Humber on Friday, the 13th of September. All proceeds go to the Queen Street Preservation Trust. At the Louth Riverhead Theatre, the audience can join Meryl Streep, Julie Walters and Colin Firth in those ever-popular ABBA hits when Mamma Mia features on the next sing-along film night. Raise your voices to Dancing Queen, Does Your Mother Know, and of course, the title track, Mamma Mia.
Oh, you always knew how to make an entrance.
Hold Truck provides a unique experience on Saturday the 31st of August and Sunday the 1st of September, when sound artist and composer Ray Lee presents Congregation. Mysterious fears lead you on a sonic voyage through to a final destination where you will encounter a meeting of the spheres, a chiming, pulsing web of electronic sound. Grimsby Auditorium begins its new season with Wannabe, the Spice Girls show, on Friday the 6th of September. And comic legend Frank Skinner stars on Friday the 6th of September.
Also in Grimsby, the Caxton Theatre's production of Boudicca, directed by John Ferguson, runs from the 7th to the 14th of September. At the Baths Hall in Scunthorpe, the hospital players present Hobson's Choice from the 3rd to the 7th of September. Wilton's production of the popular musical Chicago runs from the 10th to the 14th of September, and the Royal Philharmonic Orchestra brings you an orchestral celebration of music by British composers from Delius to Elgar in the Best of British on Friday the 20th of September. At the East Riding Theatre in Beverley, you can see the hugely talented actress, writer and comedian, Lucy Beaumont, on Sunday the 8th and Monday the 9th of September. David William Bryan in Loyal Company and Fragility of Man on Friday the 6th and Saturday the 7th of September. And on Tuesday the 10th of September, you can hear the haunting melodies of Scotland's preeminent singer-songwriter and a national music treasure, Dougie MacLean. I don't know
if you can see the changes that have come over me in these last few days. I've been afraid that I might drift away.
Well, that's almost all for this month's show. You can keep up to date with the latest entertainment news on our Facebook page, and to make sure you don't miss any of our programmes, click the subscribe button below or go to www.billboardtv.uk. If you would like us to feature your own event on Billboard TV, you can email details to news@billboardtv.uk. From everyone on the Billboard team, thank you for joining us, and we look forward to seeing you next month with more entertaining news, entertaining guests, and great music. More than sad. Caledonia's been everything I've ever had. Oh, and I have moved, and I've kept on moving. I proved the points that I needed proving. Lost the friends that I needed losing, found others on the way. Oh, and I have tried, and I've kept on trying. I've stolen dreams, yes, there's no denying. I have traveled hard, with conscience flying, somewhere with the wind. Oh, well, let me tell you that I love you, that I think about you all the time.